welcome everyone to another episode of Your Our Unity, a show that wishes to spread a spirit of peace and love in the world, one person at a time. We want to encourage you to go and pour your talents, your gifts, your love into the youth in your life. And if you don't have any youth or young ones in your life, please go and contribute, become a part of an organization, and donate your time, serve, give of yourself. We want to celebrate, we want to empower, and we want to guide our children, the future leaders of this world, into a better world. I am your host, LeShawn Walker. I'd like to welcome you in. Please like, share, follow, let everyone know that we're on right now, live from Strong Island Studios here in Long Island. I hope you guys had a wonderful week. I had a busy week. I literally just returned from North Carolina and Virginia this morning, and I am here to celebrate this amazing interview that I have with this beautiful woman today with you guys. I felt it necessary for me to rush back to New York to this heat. It was nice down in North Carolina and Virginia. I thought it was going to be a little hot. Everyone's been complaining about 100 degree weather, and we kind of received some pretty decent, beautiful, calm weather down there. And then I had to return to the heat, the concrete jungle heat that I'm experiencing today. But I'm happy to be here. I hope you guys had a wonderful weekend. I hope you stayed cool. I hope you were able to visit family and friends and just love on a few people in your life. I hope you also were able to, as I mentioned earlier in the intro, share something about yourself with a young person in your life. It is so important right now. So before I go any further, you know, I have to share with you guys everything that I did in the last couple of days and the week. So this week in Unity in the Community, we're going to be discussing. Last Tuesday after the show, I rushed home so that I can participate in the National Community Night Out event that they do every year. I believe it's the first Tuesday of every month in August. I'm sorry, in every Tuesday in August every year. And this was my first time actually participating in it. And it was really, really amazing. I saw my community come out. They had performers, they had singers. They had the army there. They had the police department there, just trying to build better community with the neighbors and the residents. I thought it was really great seeing everyone come out that day and just enjoy all the festivities that the town of Hempstead was able to offer. I understand that they did this in quite a few communities locally, but I think mine was the best. I have to be honest with you. We had bouncy houses. We had the bat car there. Like, it was really, really cool. So I hope you guys, you know, were able to participate in your community night out. And if you do, share in the comments, what did you experience? How did you enjoy yourself? What did you see? And what did you learn from this amazing night out with your community neighbors and the residents and the political figures in the neighborhood? I also had the pleasure of taking a trip to Virginia. I needed to see my mom. I haven't seen her in about a year. And I also wanted to see some family and some friends. And while I was down there, I ran into this amazing ice cream shop. It was an old style ice cream shop. You know, they had the sundae machine, and they had all these beautiful chairs and decor in there that was so inviting. This young woman, Carissa Phillips, and I was talking, and she told me what she wanted to do in the community with the youth in South Hill, Virginia. They need somewhere to just sort of have an outlet, somewhere where they can share and somewhere where they can commune together and also learn and engage in thoughtful and character building conversations. She says she wants to start a few workshops and programs. So I told her we'd be in touch with each other because I got some ideas for South Hill, Virginia, but I thought her ideas were amazing. It's not just a sundae ice cream shop, and you know I love me some ice cream. It was so much more. And I want you guys, if you ever drive through, because South Hill, Virginia is a small, small town, but if you guys ever drive through, please take some time and stop at the chill zone. The ice cream was really good. The company and the owner, even better. Beautiful one young woman and her husband as well. Young business owners opening up this Sunday shop, this ice cream shop in the middle of a small town, just hoping to spread some love, some cheer, and some happiness. And I loved it. So again, if you're in South Hill, please stop by the Chill Zone. It was so chill. Now, moving on. After that, I went to North Carolina to see my sister. I think I mentioned to you guys not too long ago that, you know, I was dealing with a heavy heart, a little sadness. It's because my sister, unfortunately, has been diagnosed with cancer. So I'm asking everyone out there, please, your prayers, your love, your support, everything that you can give and pour into her. I wish that you would do it. Lift her up, lift her up, lift her up. I love her dearly. We went to North Carolina to see the family. That is my sister, my nephew, my daughter, my beautiful niece, his wife, and her brother, Jari. And we just had a fabulous, fabulous day or two together. We got to, you know, basically just share in old stories and just talk about just our future and the plans that we had for our lives and our children. I think that she really raised a really, really good bunch of kids. And her son, Michael, my nephew, beautiful home, beautiful wife, wonderful family as a son and a daughter on the way, I believe, where we're praying it's a daughter. But I just, you know, just wanted to spend some time and love on my sister and let her know how much I'm support her and I'm there for her and whatever she needs and how much she's meant to me throughout our life growing up. She's a little older than I, wisdom, you know, she tried to impart in me. And I tried to just give her some inspiration this weekend, give her some love, give her some support. Anybody out there that is dealing with a family member who is ill, please, please go and spend some time with them. Time is so precious and fleeting. And you want to be able to give them their roses and their flowers while they're here. So I know she's going to be here for a very long time, but I just wanted to get down there and even in the heat to make sure that she knew how much I loved her and how much I am praying for her healing and her recovery. And then I was leaving from Virginia this morning. I literally left from Virginia this morning. My mom, I wish I could show you guys a picture, but she's not too keen on photos. So I didn't get one of her, but I did get one of the bird, the little bird that sleeps underneath her awning, I guess her roof, every night, she says. And then in the morning when she wakes up, it just disappears. So as I was leaving in the wee hours of the morning, I saw him nestled up in the corner. And I just wanted, I guess what he was just trying to tell is, I wish you a very safe trip as you fly back to New York, because that's exactly what I did. But I thought that it was so sweet that she has this little bird watching over her like every night. She's in the home alone. And yeah, it's comforting to know that there's something out there that's checking on her every single night. So that was my weekend in review and my week in review. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please, in the comments, let me know what you guys did. I'm sure it was exciting. If it had anything to do with family, prayer, happiness, children, youth, anything like that, I want to hear about it. So as I mentioned earlier in the conversation lately has been about the youth, empowering the youth. I was at an event a couple of weeks ago, and you guys remember, I was showing all these fabulous pictures of a fashion show I attended, and this beautiful lady, this beautiful young pageant princess queen, Selene Mira. She is the guest that we have today who's going to help us discuss how important it is for youth to be empowered. So, youth empowerment, what do you think about that? Please, in the comments, tell me how important that is to you. And the title of the show today is Future Leaders of the World, Claiming the Crown. And we have today our beautiful guest. Her name is Selene Mira Ferdinand. She is a reigning pageant queen from Elmont, New York. Selene is an entrepreneur, a co-author for Road to the Crown, Volume 2, a Girl Scout, dancer, actress, model, designer, singer, and a bit of a chef. Selene is the founder of Mirror Empowerment, which believes that the best opportunities for personal growth come from hands-on experiences. This is the inspiration behind their community service program, where they encourage participants to go out into the world, explore, and enjoy. Mirror Empowerment programs are developed with all backgrounds and skill sets in mind, providing the perfect platform to connect, learn, and grow. In 6 long years and several titles, Selene, a pint-sized 9-year-old, 4.5-foot-tall junior preteen, credits NAM, National American Miss, for giving her confidence and encouraging her to always be proud on and off the runway, even when the lights are off. NAM has made Selene put more action into her words. She gives support and helps many organizations in her community provide the necessary resources needed today. Selene hears the word hope daily. NAM has made it clear without help in one form or another, hope means nothing. Selene is here to share what we all can do to empower our youth by serving our communities. Please help me welcome the beautiful, the young, the talented, Miss Selene Mira Ferdinand. How are you, beautiful?
I'm good.
Oh my God, it's so great to have you here.
It's so great to be here.
Thank you. I really appreciate you taking the time. I am in awe of you, my friend. I really, truly are. I aspire to be you when I grow up. Like, I'm so serious. Okay. Just so you know, I got a few things to do before I can catch up with you, but I do. You are a very impressive young lady. You
Thank
really
you.
Are. No problem. So again, welcome to the You're Our Unity show. She has her sash on, ladies and gentlemen. She has her crown on. Like I said, our youth are claiming the crown. I want you to tell us real quick, because I want to dig all into what you do, how you empower the youth in your community. But first, tell me a little about your childhood, even though I know that was a few years ago. Yeah. Tell us a little about your upbringing.
So as a child, when I was 4 years old, I actually started pageants. Mm-hmm. So I got a letter in the mail asking if I wanted to join. And then, so my dad said, let's try it. So we went, and then I wanted to do it again and again. So here I am today, still doing pageants.
Wow.
So
that's nice. That's amazing. So what did you enjoy about it that you wanted to keep doing it over and over again?
So what I enjoyed is that I got to meet new friends and like tons of new people. One time I actually met a friend who was from Hawaii.
Oh, wow. That's nice. So people from all over the world then.
Yeah.
That's so cool. All right. And I'm sure, you know, meeting different people all over the world, you learn different things about their culture, right?
Yeah.
So what was, I guess, the best thing that you learned from one of your friends from a different country?
I don't know, because there's like tons of things.
Oh, wow. Okay.
It's hard to choose from.
All right. I totally understand that. Now, your friend from Hawaii then. What did you like most? Did she share any like recipes or favorite foods that she loves, or her type of style or fashion that she enjoys?
No, she didn't like share any foods or anything, but I did get to see some of her Hawaiian like clothes and stuff.
Oh, wow. Nice.
It was like really pretty.
Oh, that's so cool. I know that you're into fashion.
Yeah.
And was that also something else that kind of sparked your interest in being in pageants, because you love to dress up?
Yeah.
I could imagine. Are you like in your mom's clothes and her shoes and things like that? Yeah, I kind of figured that. I used to do that too, ladies and gentlemen, when I was younger. My daughter did it as well. So it was always about playing dress up so that you could feel beautiful, right?
Yeah.
That's so cool. So now you said 4 years old, you started off your first pageant, yeah. Then you wanted to do over and over and over again. Tell me a little about the experience. What is it like to be part of a pageant?
So to like be a part of the pageant, it's like it gives you more confidence in yourself. It makes you feel like you could do this, and like all sorts of things. Like,
It just like enables
makes
you
feel
you.
Like, for me, it makes me feel like happy and like I want to do this.
Nice. That's beautiful. So I understand, you know, NAM, the National American Miss, they had a lot to do with your confidence and helping you build that. Did you know what confidence was when you started to gain it? Did you understand what it actually meant before they were, you know, pouring that into you?
No, because as a kid, I was actually very shy. Mm-hmm. I would, like, hide behind my mom's leg. So I didn't really know what that meant.
Oh, wow. That's something. So the National NAM, I'm going to just continue to call it NAM. It's a lot to say. NAM, they taught you confidence. What else did they teach you at this organization?
So they also taught us how to, like, be brave to go after dreams and, like, not to make anyone tell you that you can't do this mm-hmm. and that you're not worth it. And, like, you just can't do it.
Yeah, no, I think that's valuable, valuable lessons and information to instill in you. Young kids need to know that they are capable of any and everything. And we also need to let them know that they are smart, they are brave, they can tackle anything and any challenge that's put before them. Do you feel that now that you've
yeah.
gone through this process? There's nothing that scares you or puts fear in you?
Yeah.
What? Tell me a little about fear.
So actually, I am scared of heights.
Okay.
And sometimes, like, when you do go out in public, although once you do it often, you get used to it, but yeah. sometimes you still feel that, like, that you're scared
yeah.
and, like, all that sort of stuff, like, I don't want to go out there. Like, I can't do it.
I understand. So you do get, like, a little nervous when
yeah.
you first hit the runway, right?
Yeah.
And then when does your confidence that you've built, when does that sort of hit? Is it your first step, your second step?
So, like, when I first get on the stage, it's like, oh, my gosh, what is going on? And then, like, after, like, a couple seconds, mm-hmm. I start to, like, calm down and, like, I actually feel like it's fun.
Yeah.
Like, I'm happy. I'm like, the next time I'm going to walk on the stage with, like, a ton of confidence.
Yes, yes. So basically, every time you go out there, you're getting stronger and stronger.
Yeah.
And that's basically what everyone does, is every time they have to face something, and even if they are afraid of it in the beginning, they develop this strength, this tenacity, and they just keep going, and they just get stronger and stronger and better at it. And it sounds like that's exactly what you're doing in this short little time that you've been doing this. Girl, you're only 9 years old. So tell me, considering you're only 9, and I know that you've won quite a few titles, what is the, I guess, the best title that you've received, or the one that's closest to your heart so far?
I think the one that is closest to my heart is probably the New York title, which is the one I'm wearing right now.
Nice.
And
beautiful.
So I think I'm closer to that title because then I get to, like, do more things mm-hmm. and, like, help more people and get more, like, involved.
Right.
And, like, I get to do so many more things.
Right. That's amazing. That's really, really cool. So basically, this organization that you're a part of, that you're able to share not only your talents, you're also able to share what is close and near and dear to your heart, which is your advocacy work. So I understand that you are very passionate about giving back.
Yeah.
I understand that you've been giving back probably just as long
yeah.
as you've been doing pageants.
Yeah.
So you used to visit the elderly in the nursing homes, which I think is so impressive. So tell us a little about that.
So when we would go to, like, the nursing homes and stuff, we would like collect teddy bears, magazines, and we would like make little cards, and then we would give it out to all of the patients. And all the patients, it would make like me smile to just see them smile.
Nice.
And it's like, it's so nice.
Yeah, no, it is. It is. I find it so important that the youth form a relationship with the elderly. They have so much wisdom and they love to share stories and they want to impart something new and different into you, as well as you sharing something new and different with them. I'm sure you know that the elderly are not very technologically advanced. You know, yeah. Trust me, my mom, I tried to show her the show. She doesn't have internet. She doesn't want to learn how to use it. It's a whole big thing. Maybe you need to go visit my mom. But anyway, so basically what it is sharing in where you are with them so that they can share the same with you and you can learn from each other. Did you do that while you were visiting the elderly? Did you learn anything impactful from the elderly?
Well, I learned that sometimes they actually have people that visit them.
Yeah.
So it actually made me really happy to actually see them.
Yeah.
Because it could have been the first person who saw them like months.
Yeah.
Maybe even like a year.
Yeah. No, you're absolutely right. That's why I really, really strongly encourage all youth organizations to put together a crew of kids and just have them visit. Because again, you're right. There's some people that are in these nursing homes that hasn't seen a family member or a friend in years. And they're basically just there. And it's unfortunate, but it's true. So I'm so glad that you and I believe your brother and even your friends were able to participate in spreading some sunshine, as I say, some sunshine on the elderly. I know you guys enjoyed it, right?
Yeah, actually one year, me and all my queen sisters, mm-hmm. we had went to the same nursing home and we all had given out and they had do like bingo and
wow.
stuff. And then we had raffle out some like jewelry and all sorts of like fun stuff they would like.
That's so cool. I love that. See, come on. What? This is what we can do. We can pour into our youth so that they can make this world a better place. She is doing things that I didn't even consider doing at her age. So I'm so impressed. So I know the pandemic revealed a lot of things in your neighborhood.
Yeah.
I understand your mom, who is a beautiful, wonderful, amazing woman, and who supports you with all of her heart and her soul, is also the PTA president.
Yeah.
So you guys were able to sort of get a first bird's eye view into what's going on in your community. And
yeah.
So what did you see? What was uncovered during the pandemic?
During the pandemic, I realized that like lots of people were suffering from different crises, like they lost their jobs and like they can't find one because then they're asking for vaccine cards
yeah.
and all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, it was rough. And I know there was a lot of kids also, you know, families that were affected financially, if they lost their job or if, you know, they didn't have a job and this just sort of shined the light on them in the first place, the fact that, you know, the pandemic came and no one was able to find employment. I know you saw quite a few kids like go yeah. without food and things of that nature. So tell me, how did you help those kids in your community and those families in your community that were suffering with, you know, food insecurity?
Actually, we do cook at Ronald McDonald House.
Okay.
And we take like canned foods and donate it and stuff. Actually, the Elmont Memorial High School food drive, they like pack food bags and they donate it every Wednesday.
Wow. So did you start that or was that something that they were already doing and then you just started to contribute every Wednesday?
So the school started and I started to contribute. I couldn't go every day because then school had started, and then it was like busy. Mm-hmm. But actually, we were thinking to actually go tomorrow.
Oh, wow. Really? Yeah. Maybe we need to meet you there tomorrow. What do you guys usually collect?
So we collect canned foods.
Okay.
And like chicken, beans, and all sorts of stuff. And then we pack it, and then they would give them out.
Wow.
It's like a food drive.
Right.
Yeah.
So the community comes and meets you at the food bank, the location, and then give them the bag or the box, or you pack it in their car and they just keep going. Wow. That's really, really amazing. And you guys have been doing this for your community since the pandemic, and it's still ongoing, right? I mean, obviously the need is still there. Mm-hmm. Wow. So let me ask you, in terms of how that makes you feel, seeing kids who are, you know, not as fortunate, and the fact that you, you know, have food on your table, thank God, you know, your parents, you know, have, you know, the financial means to provide for you, as well as, you know, keep you in these amazing pageants and things, and contributing and donating all over the nation, because you don't only just serve, you contribute financially as well. So let me ask you, how did that make you feel, like seeing all of that?
Actually, it made me feel very sad to see that they can't afford or have food to eat every day.
Yeah.
And it kind of like messes up your brain. Like, you need like energy, and food gives you energy.
You're absolutely right. That's why it's so important that we are always giving back to the youth, especially when it has to do with finances and food, the basic essentials, those things that we do need in order to thrive, in order for us to live, in order for us to be happy, in order for us to be able to think, you know, because as you mentioned, you need nourishment in order for you to be able to think, and for you to move, and for you to just live a happy, healthy life. So I'm so glad that you were able to experience and see where the void was, and to fill it, because that's very important. Is it easy getting the youth involved? I mean, it's hard sometimes getting adults to participate. They, as I think I mentioned to you, I'm used to, you know, just giving out money and saying what else and how much do you need. I wasn't really about getting down deep and dirty into the serving. Now I am. I am all about it. But when I was younger, it was just, how much do you need? And I would donate in that way. So I want to know how hard or easy, because I mean, you are Selene Mirror Empowerment. So how easy or hard was it for you to encourage these kids to want to give back?
It is rather easy,
okay,
but sometimes it can be difficult. Like, some kids, they don't want to do it.
Mm.
And then you have to like influence them and say, maybe like it can be a benefit to your life, and all sorts of things. And it comes with like prizes, and like when you like do good, like good always comes back to you.
Yes. Yes. That is very true. And I know you feel fulfilled after you give back, right?
Yeah.
I mean, because that smile says it all. So I know that you feel good inside and out when you give back.
Yeah.
And I'm sure you're sharing that with the youth as well, that, oh my God, it feels amazing. That's how I feel when I do something. When I really, you know, like put my all into something, especially an organization or cause that benefits so many and that can help change or make changes in this world, I feel so full, and I feel inspired to continue to do more, or to just exceed what I'm already doing. So if I have a dollar amount that I'm trying to reach, I have to surpass that. If I have a certain amount of items I need to collect, I need to surpass that, because there's never ever not going to be the need for something, from somewhere, for someone, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I get it. So I heard you're a Girl Scout. Tell us a little about what it is to be a Girl Scout.
So as a Girl Scout, with my Girl Scout troop, we do a lot of things in the community. We learn about things and stuff. But sometimes they are some fun things. Actually, this year we went to medieval times.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And it's like a full meal they served. Mm-hmm. And it was really nice.
Nice.
And like when we walked in, it was like an actual castle, like a dungeon.
Right.
It looks so realistic.
Yeah.
It was really good.
No, I heard that it's this old time type of event and that the food, like you're really eating like a true drumstick or big, huge piece of meat from back in the day. Yeah.
It's like so big.
Yes.
It's like, I can't eat all of it.
Well, I'm glad that you enjoyed yourself. So you do a lot of trips like this with the Girl Scouts. It's always about giving back.
Yeah.
Yeah. I will tell you, I love the cookies. I truly enjoy the cookies. So if you have any at home that you're trying to sell, please let me know. Okay. We'll talk about it at the end of the show. Okay. So again, you're a Girl Scout. Now, it sounds like everything about you since you were 4 years old is about serving. Yeah. So I understand NAM. In National American Miss, and also encourages that strongly that you participate in contributing to a cause, giving back to your community in some way, some form. And then I think I understand you decided, because you were already doing this in the community and with so many different organizations, that you were going to be an entrepreneur and founder, CEO, and start your own organization that empowers the youth called Mirror Empowerment. Yes. First of all, impressive, amazing. I am just in awe of you again, as I mentioned earlier. What is Mirror Empowerment? What does it mean for our youth? And how did you even come up with that?
So Mirror Empowerment is a nonprofit organization. So the money we raise will be donated to help stop hunger and homelessness. And, well, how we came up with it is that, as you said, I started doing community service and all sorts of stuff. And with National American Miss, actually, they changed their name to I Am Pageant Powerhouse.
Okay. I like that.
Because they took another pageant, IJM, and combined it with National American Miss.
Wow, nice, impressive. Okay, so Mirror Empowerment, it basically in an organization that you started because you were already doing community service and you figured, why not start your own and be the face of and a leader in your community. What are some of the programs that Mirror Empowerment has?
So actually, July 16th, we had a fun fashion show.
Yes.
And last year, we had another fashion show. And we had a henna tea party. Mm-hmm. This is like a nice, cute, fun tea party. And we did like henna. And it was really nice.
I love it. I love it. I was there at the fashion show and oh my God, it was so amazing to see the youth just shine. They looked so happy. They looked empowered. They looked like they had such self-confidence and self-esteem. They were strutting that runway. I had pictures a couple of weeks ago. I showed the whole thing. You're going to have to revisit that show. But I showed quite a few of the young ladies and the young men that were walking down that runway. And it was truly a sight to see. What was going through your mind that night? Because I saw you too. That was the first night I met you, actually. What was going through your night? Because it was huge. It was a really, really extravagant event. So what was going through your mind?
I actually didn't get to see the model because I was also modeling. So I was backstage getting dressed and stuff. Mm-hmm. For me, it was kind of like a rush because after this outfit, I had to go straight into this.
Right.
And like, that's kind of like with actual pageants, because it's always like a rush. You have to do this. And sometimes they do it like so early and it goes like so late.
Wow.
So it's hard to like keep up.
Right. Yeah. But you did. You were able to do it. I mean, you came out there, different outfit, different hairstyle, different look, shining, just shining. It was truly a sight to see. And I love the fact that I was able to see all of these young kids who, you know, probably if I hadn't seen them in those extravagant, elegant outfits, they probably would have been very shy individuals. Mm-hmm. But for whatever reason, that night, it just made them glow. And I have a feeling that it has a lot to do with what you represent and what you kind of instill in them and what you're showing them. Now, being part of the pageant world, I know that you've been doing it for the last 6 or so years. Do you see yourself doing this further into the future? You want to do this well into college?
Actually, I hope to do it like as long as I can.
Wow.
One day I hope to become Miss Universe or Miss World.
Yes, I love it. And you will, my friend, and you will.
Thank you.
Now, I love the fact that you are also all about inclusivity, diversity, and just sharing in one's cultures. At the fashion event, I saw that you guys modeled a few designs
like
from different cultures.
Yeah.
I'm sorry about that. I couldn't get it out. But anyway, you modeled a few designs from different cultures. So how was that? What did the kids think and how did they feel about, you know, trying on these beautiful designs from different lands?
Actually, for me, it was actually really exciting.
Mm-hmm.
And for the other girls, I think they really liked it. And the boys, because some of my friends, they got to try on like Indian outfits.
Yeah.
And they've never gotten to wear one.
Yeah.
So it was really exciting.
Yeah.
And so I got to wear an African outfit.
Yes. I love it. I love
it. It's really nice.
No, it really, really is. I think it's important that we share different cultures also with our youth. And I've always mentioned it before, not just through the food, you know, just Italian and, you know, Spanish and Thai. And I mean, actually through interactions, speaking with one another, maybe a book. Even the clothing, I think, is very important that you share that. So I think that's wonderful that you guys were able to showcase and highlight that at your event. The fashion show, again, was amazing. I can't wait for next year. I know it's going to be even grander than it was a couple of weeks ago. So I'm excited for it. Now, I read in your bio, you are a million things, my friend. And again, like I said, aspiring to be entrepreneur. You are a Girl Scout, we mentioned, dancer, actress, model, designer, but you're also a co-author of a book.
Yes, I am actually the co-author of the book, Road to the Crown, with 17 other beauty pageant girls. So this book's about like how we could do community service and how like we can make an impact in our communities and like maybe even the world.
Mm-hmm.
Like we could do so many things to inspire the youth and like other girls, because some girls, they still do get taken down and then like all sorts of things.
Right. Yeah. No, it's hard, especially in this world today, this technologically advanced world and social media and all of that. I don't know if you're on social media like that. I know for your organization, you probably have to be on there, but it can be dangerous for young girls, body, you know, issues and just having to deal with bullying online and just unkind people. So what would you say to people out there, especially young ladies who are trying to find that confidence and who unfortunately are probably dealing with issues right now, whether it's bullying or, you know, body insecurity issues or whatever the case may be? What would you like to share with them?
What I would say, just ignore them. Sometimes they're actually just jealous of you and they just want to be like you.
Mm-hmm.
And just be yourself. Just ignore all the bullies. One thing I really hate is cyberbullying.
Yeah.
That's really bad. But when you actually bully someone in person,
mm-hmm.
that's like even worse because they could like physically like hit you.
Yeah.
And like they could really hurt you mentally and physically.
Yeah. No, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. It is bad. It's horrible that it's still going on, you know, considering that, you know, we have all of the resources and tools available to us. Like, just like you can find something bad on the internet and on social media, you can find very encouraging and inspiring things on there as well. Things that are going to encourage you and empower you. So I think that, you know, that's basically what we should all be doing every single day. Instead of looking to the internet and social media, you know, just for entertainment, let's look into it for inspiration and supporting people and encouraging others and empowering like you're doing in your community, right? Doesn't that sound like something to do?
Yeah.
I love it. Okay. Now, let me ask you, how do you, you said it wasn't really hard in a way to encourage your friends and your community to get involved. But let me ask you, how is it for the adults? Do you have a lot of adults that are also participating in the events and the things that you're putting on?
There was some adults. Last year, my friend's mom actually did it.
Oh, wow.
She did wonderful. And last year we had my best friend's mom, she had modeled and she was actually the past Miss Elmont.
Oh, wow. Really?
Yeah.
They have a past Miss Elmont? Are you going for that title? Are you snatching that title?
No.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Just not yet, but soon when you get to that age. Wow, there is a Miss Elmont. That is so cool. So she, and obviously, wasn't hard to convince her to become part of whatever you guys are doing. Yeah. I love it. I love it. Well, I understand that you also, in addition to the food pantry, you also work with, I think, Building Homes for Heroes.
Yes.
What is that about?
So Building Homes for Heroes is an organization that is also with my school.
Okay.
And so we collect recycling bottles and they would make homes for like veterans because sometimes when they come back from war, mm-hmm. they don't have a place to stay.
Right.
And like they don't have to pay for it. It's totally free.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. So how often or how do you receive the donations or charity, whatever you receive for these people for the Building Homes for Heroes? How do you receive the donations?
So actually, we do like collect bottles,
mm-hmm.
and you do get to like money back from
it. So you ask the community to collect the bottles, and then
and we give it to the school and like recycle it and stuff.
That's so
and they
cool.
make homes.
So what do you do? Like the kids, I guess the community go out because I see a lot of that in my community, that there'll be teams of people that are cleaning up, obviously, and then they'll go through garbage and things like that, and they'll pick out the bottles, and then they'll donate them to, like, I guess, the local organization. So that's what you guys are doing as well.
Yeah.
That is so nice. I really love that. Now, the Building Homes for the Heroes, these are, as you mentioned, veterans, right?
Yes.
Is it veterans within your local community or is it veterans all over?
I'm not too sure
about
that.
Okay. All right. I just want to know, just in case we want to direct people there and let them know that they are serving your local community. Now, you're also part of Island Harvest. And the Sun Harbor Manor Nursing Home I mentioned, but Island Harvest, what is that about?
So Island Harvest is also donating food and also, so they collect food, like canned foods, mm-hmm. like the Belmont Memorial High School food drive.
Right.
And they would donate it. And like they have this place and it's like full of like food and snacks and stuff and they like wrap it up and like donate it to like children all over the country.
And
I'm not too sure about the world.
Right. But they're just, they're donating to those that need, and that's important. That's really awesome. I'm so serious, Selene. You make me feel like I'm not doing enough, my friend. You really, really do. So tonight, I don't know, I'm going to be researching some organizations, maybe contributing to a few that you're a part of. I'm just so really impressed with everything that you're doing. Now, with all that you're doing, how do you have time to be a nine-year-old? What do you enjoy doing? What is your favorite thing to do when you're not being a beauty queen?
So I do like to spend time with my brother, Stefan, mm-hmm. and I also love to paint and, like, draw.
Nice.
And I'm not too sure what I like.
Well, I mean, obviously, you like to cook, you like to dance, you like to sing, you like
There's
to do
a lot of things.
You like to do it. And there goes your brother. Aw. Yeah. Look, real quick, I heard there's a little story about your first pageant. Yeah. And you were supposed to have like an adult or an older kid escort you. And you just was not having that. You were not interested at all. And you requested that your brother escort you. Tell us real quick. Tell us that story real quick.
So actually, my brother wasn't going to escort me. They're going to put me on stage with another kid. Mm-hmm. I don't know him. No idea who he is. And I just refused to go on stage with that kid.
Right.
So my brother had to come and escort me.
Wow.
And then he just continued escorting me from that day on.
Yeah. No, I think it's beautiful. You guys look so adorable together.
Thank you.
And again, he's got some swag to him, my friend, too. I don't know. I think he's going to be, I don't know what they call the men's pageants, but I really foresee a future in modeling for him as well. He was part of the fashion show as well, guys, and he was amazing, amazing.
Yeah.
I know you probably have some pictures or something up on your website soon, so you guys can always go to mirrorempowerment.com.org and you could check out the website and see what she's got going on. So again, your support system. You mentioned your brother. Tell us about your mom, that amazing superwoman that you have in the back here. Tell us about your mom.
So my mom is my role model. She's always been there for me to cheer me on, to cheer me up.
Yes.
And she's just, like, actually, when my dad suggested to do pageants, then after a while, he said, I'm going to let it go. Maybe let's not do it anymore. And then I really wanted to do it again. So my mom's like saying, I'm going to take this over.
Wow.
I'm going to take all of this over.
Wow. That is awesome. And she has just been by your side all the way, right?
Yeah.
I know. I see you guys' relationship and I think it's beautiful. I think it's special. I think it's something that all children, especially daughters, should be able to have with their mom. You know, like I can see you guys being best friends when you get older, you know, because of how close you are now. You don't have to learn her. She doesn't have to learn you. You know each other very, very well. But I know that she's a huge support. She's actually the one who facilitates all of your pageantry and everything that you have going on. How is that? Does it get tiring sometimes? Be honest.
Yeah. Sometimes it is really exhausting. Mm. And like when you have to plan all sorts of stuff.
Right.
And then like you stay up like so late. Actually, today and yesterday, me and my mom were searching for a pageant dress because I'm going as royalty in October and I'm competing in November.
Oh, wow. You have a lot going on.
Wait, I'm going as royalty in August, this month.
This month,
yeah.
Okay. And then you compete in November or October?
November.
In November. Wow. So every year there's a pageant, obviously, and you're competing. Are you always competing as Miss New York, Miss Elmo? How are you competing?
So get like, for the state, you get a state title.
Okay.
And so you have to like compete with other girls to win like Miss New York and the other titles.
I see.
And then for the nationals, you compete to get the national title.
Oh, wow. That's awesome. And you've run quite a few. Like, you've held two or three titles within a year before, right?
Yeah.
You're doing it even presently right now, correct?
Yeah.
I thought so. So you're relinquishing your title in November, or is it this month? You're relinquishing your title, passing it down?
This month, I'm passing down New York Cover Girl.
Mm-hmm.
So presently now, I'm holding three titles.
Okay. All right. Okay. And what are those three titles, real quick?
The first title is New York Cover Girl, and then Miss New York, and then National Cover Cover Girl.
Excellent. I love it. Real quick, what about your father? How is he supportive, other than saying to you at 4 years old, let's try it, let's do it? Is he still happy that you're a part of the pageant, or, you know, is he broke? Tell me, which one?
So he is so excited. Actually, one time when I won the title, mm-hmm. he actually started to cry.
Oh, I know everyone is so proud and happy for you. Like, you're mm-hmm. really doing some amazing things at such a young age. So again, I am, and I'm going to continue to say it, I am so inspired and in awe of you, my beautiful queen.
Thank you.
And I thank you so much for being here. Now, again, here is her book. It is Road to the Crown. I want you to tell us real quick, give us something. What is on your heart? What would you like to share with the viewers?
So what I would like to share with the viewers is that you're never too young to make a difference. And you don't need a crown to be a winner. It's your confidence and courage that makes you a winner.
Yes. Yes. Continue. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt you. Keep going. That was beautiful. There's nothing else you want to add?
No.
And you're absolutely right. It takes nothing but your confidence to overcome every and anything.
You just need to, like, be yourself.
Just be yourself. That's right. I love it. Dare to be you. So we're going to get your information up real quick. Selene, we have you on Facebook. We have you at your website is mirrorempowerment.org, correct?
Yes.
And what is your Facebook?
My Facebook is Selene Ferdinand.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And also, I think your Instagram is the same.
Yes.
So what's happening for you in the next year? What are your plans for the next year or so?
The next year? I'm not too sure. There's probably going to be a ton of things.
Yes.
A whole ton.
Yes.
So busy.
Busy.
The same old things.
Mm-hmm. Excited.
Pageants. And the fundraisers and events with my organization.
Yes.
The same thing practically. But then there's other things, like I'm like trying something new, and that's practically it.
I love it. I love it. I truly, truly love it. Well, again, I like to thank you so much for being here. You have been truly a delight. And I want you guys all out there to know that this is what we're empowering, this beautiful youth right here who is claiming her crown. Let's go out there and guide and celebrate and help. Let other youth, like this beautiful young queen here, go out and claim theirs as well. So I want to get to the dare to be you real quick. And the dare to be you is, why is youth empowerment important to you? And not just you, but you, Y-O-U, you're our unity. It is important because youth empowerment is important to me because when empowering the youth and future of the world, we give them the power of change and the power to break cycles that have been caused or that have caused problems in the past. Do you agree with that?
Yes.
I totally agree with that as well. We have to empower our youth so that we can provide them with all the necessary tools and the resources needed to make the changes that this world needs. And we need some serious changes right now, right?
Yes.
Sure, you're not into politics or anything, and I know you don't watch the news because, you know, You're a beauty queen and all. But if you could change anything about the world right now, what would it be?
If I were to change anything about the world, it would be to help stop hunger and homelessness, because there are a lot of people suffering from, like, even like diseases.
Yeah.
The coronavirus.
Yeah.
Monkeypox.
Yeah.
And all sorts of things, like, to stop all diseases like cancer.
Yeah.
Autism.
Yeah. Yeah. You just want to stop suffering altogether. I love it. I think that is a great hope and desire, you know, and I really feel that you're going to be able to do it. I'm seeing big, huge, amazing things in your future, young lady. I hope that whatever dreams that you wish and try to accomplish, that you don't let anything stand in your way. And I know that you already have that in you, that confidence and that self-esteem. But as you get older, different influences, principalities, things just try to take, don't allow it to do it. You are a rising star, so keep rising, okay? So thank you so much, Selene, for being here. I truly appreciate it. We're going to have you back because you're winning more titles. You're probably going to have two or three more books that we need to talk about, so you will be back, okay? But I thank you so much for being here, okay?
Thank you for inviting me.
No problem. You have been truly a joy. And again, guys, go out there and pour into our youth, empower our youth, show them that we're here for them and that we want to teach them the ways to make this world a better place. Where we messed up, we want you to fix it. Where we didn't succeed, we want you to rise above and to the challenge. So I'd like to thank you guys so much for joining us for another episode of Your Our Unity. Remember that peace and love is in the palm of our hands. Let's go out there and be some love, share some love, give some love. Yes. I'd like to thank you so much. I want you to have a wonderful week. Thank our guest here, Selene Mira Ferdinand. Please look out for this amazing, beautiful woman. She is doing great things, not only in her community, but this world. And I'm looking forward to seeing it. I want you to have a good night. We will see you next week. God bless. I love you. And thank you, Strong Island Studios. Say good night.
Good night.
Good night. Everyone.